너 아이유 알지? 그녀는 너무 예쁜 것 같아.
뭔 소리야? 저기.
방금 그녀라고 하니까 어떻게 들려?
그냥 아이유는 너무 예뻐라고 하면 되지. 왜 굳이 그녀라고 하는지 모르겠는데.
그래? 뭔가 어색하지? Many videos teach that you translate as 당신, he as 그, she as 그녀, and they as 그들. But in reality, we Koreans never use these words in daily conversation. In fact, I've never used 당신, 그, or 그녀 in my life. However, I've noticed that many students learning Korean tend to use these words quite often. That's why I'm here to make sure you don't use these words when you talk. I've spent many days making this video just for you, so watch this video to the end and your Korean skills will jump into the next level. Number one, I. Many of you might already know how to say I in Korean. First, it's important to know that Korean has formal and informal speech levels. In formal speech, I is 저 or 제. The form changes based on the particle that follows. If there is a subject marker, it becomes 제가. If there is a topic marker, it becomes 저는. If there is an object marker, it becomes 저를. And when talking about something belonging to me, it's 제 something. Let's see some examples. 저는 밥을 먹어요. 저는 밥을 먹어요. 제가 요리했어요. 제가 요리했어요. 민수는 저를 좋아해요. 민수는 저를 좋아해요. 제 친구는 가수예요. 제 친구는 가수예요. Now let's look at the informal speech. When I is followed by a subject marker, it's 내가. By a topic marker, it's 나는. By an object marker, 나를. And when referring to something of mine, it's 내 something. Let's change the same examples into informal speech. 나는 밥을 먹어. 나는 밥을 먹어. 내가 요리했어. 내가 요리했어. 민수는 나를 좋아해. 민수는 나를 좋아해. 내 친구는 가수야. 내 친구는 가수야. Number two, you. Actually, you is one of the hardest words to translate into Korean because there's no exact match for English word you in Korean. Surprising, right? If you look up you in Google Translate, it might show 너, but you should never say 너 with someone older than you because it's informal. Or the word 당신 might appear in dramas, movies, or song lyrics, but it sounds really weird in daily conversation. Because 당신 is typically only found in script or literary contexts, and using 당신 can feel cringy and too dramatic, almost as if you're acting in a drama. When you want to use formal speech for you either replace it with the person's title or just omit it. For example, if the person is a teacher, you might say, 선생님, 오늘 뭐 해요? 선생님, 오늘 뭐 해요? If the person is a taxi driver, you might say, 기사님, 운전을 잘하시네요. 기사님, 운전 잘하시네요. If you don't know the person's name or title and want to say you're amazing, instead of 당신 멋져요, you just say 멋져요. 멋져요. If you know the person's name, you can say name plus 씨. For example, 미라 씨, 멋지네요. And luckily, there is an informal word for you in Korean, which is 너 or 네. When you pronounce 네, 네 is correct according to standard pronunciation. It often sounds like 네, so they can be confusing. So people usually pronounce it just 니. Okay? For example, with a subject marker, it becomes 니가. With a topic marker, it's 너는. With an object marker, it's 너를. And when talking about something belonging to you, it's 네 something. Here are some examples. 너는 무슨 음식 좋아해? 너는 무슨 음식 좋아해? 네가 김밥 만들었어? 네가 김밥 만들었어? 민지가 너를 좋아해. 민지가 너를 좋아해. 네 사진 좀 보내줘. 네 사진 좀 보내줘. Number three, he and she. I'll search he and she on Google Translate. He translates as 그 and she as 그녀. But this is only half right. Like the word 당신, 그 and 그녀 are really used in actual conversation. I'll call another friend and use these words to show you.
Why?
너 아이유 알지?
어.
그녀는 너무 예쁜 것 같아.
뭔 소리야?
방금 그녀라고 하니까 어떻게 들려?
그냥 아이유는 너무 예뻐라고 하면 되지. 왜 굳이 그녀라고 하는지 모르겠는데.
그래? 뭔가 어색하지?
어.
So, how should we naturally say he or she? Like you, it's better to use the person's name or title. If you don't know who this person is, you can simply say 그 사람. If the person is male, you can say 그 남자. And if the person is female, 그 여자 works too. For example, if he or she is a police officer, you can say, I met a police officer, he asked me a question. 경찰을 만났어요. 경찰이 저한테 질문을 했어요. You repeat 경찰 instead of using he or she. Or you can combine the sentences. 경찰을 만났는데 저한테 질문을 했어요. 경찰을 만났는데 저한테 질문을 했어요. And if you want to talk about a woman, and if you know the woman's name is Jisoo, then you can say, I went to Jisoo's house and I played a game with her. 지수 집에 갔어요. 그리고 지수랑 같이 게임했어요. You repeat 지수 instead of using she. Or as before, you can combine the sentences together. 지수 집에 가서 같이 게임했어요. 지수 집에 가서 같이 게임했어요. Number 4, we. The word we has both formal and informal versions in Korean. Formally, we say 저희 and informally 우리. Interestingly, unlike other pronouns, we does not change according to the particles attached to it. In formal speech, we use phrases like 저희는 with topic marker, 저희가 with subject marker, 저희를 with object marker, and 저희 something, our something. In informal speech, it's 우리는, 우리가, 우리를, and 우리 something. It's a bit simpler than others, right? Let's look at the examples. First, the formal version. 저희는 학생이에요. 저희는 학생이에요. 슬기가 저희를 좋아해요. 슬기가 저희를 좋아해요. 저희가 교실을 청소했어요. 저희가 교실을 청소했어요. 저희 학교는 너무 좋아요. 저희 학교는 너무 좋아요. Now, let's change them into the informal version. 우리는 학생이야. 우리는 학생이야. 슬기가 우리를 좋아해. 슬기가 우리를 좋아해. 우리가 교실을 청소했어. 우리가 교실을 청소했어. 우리 학교는 너무 좋아. 우리 학교는 너무 좋아. Number 5, day. Lastly, let's look at day. If you search for day on Google Translate, it shows up as 그들. However, just like 당신, 그, and 그녀, this word isn't used in real conversation. The suffix 들 is a plural marker in Korean used to indicate multiple things. So in real conversations, we attach 들 to the noun describing the group, like 학생들, students, or 사람들, people. If there is no specific title for the group, we use 사람들, which means people. Sometimes we can even omit 대 if it's clear from context who we are talking about. For example, 콘서트에 유명한 가수들이 왔어요. 가수들이 노래를 다 잘 불렀어요. Or, 콘서트에 유명한 가수들이 왔어요. 노래를 다 잘 불렀어요. 헬스장에 사람이 너무 많아요. 사람들이 다 운동하고 있어요. 헬스장에 사람들이 너무 많아요. 다 운동하고 있어요. Today, we've learned how Koreans actually use the words I, you, he, she, we, and they in real conversations. Was this video helpful for you? These expressions are the basics, but many people found them difficult due to various rules. That's why I created this video to show you how Koreans really speak. I know many of you are curious about real-life expressions used in various situations, so I'm currently working hard on writing a book that will include only expressions used by native Koreans. I'll let you know in the pinned comments below as soon as it's released. It's coming soon, so please stay tuned. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to subscribe and like this video. I'll be back with more fun and useful Korean content next time. See you in the next video. 안녕!